Finally, the Mac Pro Cheese Grater from 2008 to 12 is enabled for macOS 13 Ventura. So yesterday night, the developers of the OpenCore Legacy Patcher released their new version 0.6. And just a few hours later, that was the version already 0.6.1 as a minor bug fixing version. But this 0.6 series enables very many very old Macs, generally starting in 2008. The iMac starts already in 2007, and the MacBook Air and the Mac Mini starts in 2009. And all those old Macs are now enabled for macOS Ventura. And by the way, let me give you a little sneak peek to the next video, the ultimate guide of Mac Pro. So you have a Mac Pro 5.1 from 2012 and a Mac Pro 6.1 from 2013 with an eGPU, an external graphic card. I give you the information. Is it still worth buying or upgrading these 10-year-old Macs? What is the performance? And a full detailed tutorial how to connect an eGPU, an external graphic card, to your Mac Pro 6.1, because you cannot change the graphic cards in there. I know that so many of you guys that had the Mac Pro Cheese Grater as a workhorse are waiting desperately for this version, and now it is officially released and the Mac Pro is enabled for Ventura. I had no time yet to test it on my Mac Pro, but I definitely will, and I also will test it on the Mac Pro 6.1, which was enabled by version 0.5 already for Ventura, but it was quite buggy and unstable. And if you haven't yet, I would recommend you subscribe the channel and click the bell for notification so you don't miss any update. I'm also in the process of updating my MacBook Pro 2012 and the MacBook Air 2013 with macOS 13.2 that was also released yesterday. And I'm gonna give you feedback how the update went through, if there are any problems, and if you can safely update your old unsupported Macs to 13.2 with a new OpenCore Legacy Patcher. And if you want to tune your old Mac before you do an update, I recommend Clean My Mac X from MacPaw. And down in the video description, you'll find a link that gives you a great offer and it supports my channel. Thank you. So let's get through the changelog, through the release notes of the new OpenCore Legacy Patcher, so you have an idea what had changed and what now enables these old Macs for Ventura, and what might be the hiccups if you should already go that way, or maybe wait a little until maybe the new version is released. So the first thing the developers had to implement into the Legacy Patcher was the non-metal graphic cards. All Macs older than 2012, generally speaking, don't have metal-enabled graphic cards. So you see here the AMD TerraScale, the NVIDIA Tesla, Maxwell and Pascal, and Intel Iron Lake and Sandy Bridge graphic units were implemented now with the graphic drivers, and they can handle the metal requirements now of macOS. And that means that nearly all models from 2008, iMac 2007, Mac Mini 2009, now are metal capable with the OpenCore Legacy Patcher. Next, the developers had to implement was support for dropped Wi-Fi and Bluetooth modules, because Apple dropped support for the very old ones and they had to bring it back so that your Wi-Fi Bluetooth is still working with macOS Ventura. Then you can see the USB problematic, and that was one of the biggest reasons why the old Mac Pro Cheese Grater was not enabled for Ventura yet. Apple dropped support for the old USB 1.1 USB controllers. For instance, keyboard and mouse requires the USB 1.1 USB controller, and they managed to bring the support back during the bootloader. But there's one downside to that. The USB doesn't work in the boot selector and in the open core selector. So you have to use a USB hub, a USB 2.0 hub. The reason for that is simple. Apple hardwired the USB 1.1 controller and the USB 2 controller to the ports. And depending on the device you plug in, the system decides which controller to use. And if you plug in a keyboard or a mouse, that's very simple USB devices, it uses the USB 1.1 controller. But the support is dropped, so this controller doesn't work anymore, so your keyboard or mouse doesn't work anymore. And that even happens with MacBooks that you can see here, that the integrated keyboard and touchpad doesn't work. They manage to bring back USB 1.1 functionality, but only when the macOS loads. So when you have the login screen, mouse and keyboard works again. And to manage to select whatever you need in the Apple boot selector or in the OpenCore boot selector, you need a USB hub. And that is a trick. You use a USB 2.0 hub, and that's like a passive hub, very cheap thing. You just plug in between the Mac and mouse and keyboard. And even though the devices are USB 1.1, the hub is USB 2.0. And that forces the Mac to use the USB 2.0 controller, which is still supported. And the hub just routes the USB 1 device onto your USB 2.0 controller, which is still working. Now the good news for the Mac Pro 6.1 users from 2013, they implemented support for AMD Radeon Vega and Radeon 7. So you will say, okay, there is no Vega in my Mac Pro 13, that's correct. But many of you, like I do, use an eGPU, an external graphic unit, and there is a Vega or a Radeon 7 in it. And these drivers have been restored. And the last thing is more like a technical thing. The developers added support for the rapid security responses in Haswell on newer Macs. That is a new functionality that Apple integrated into macOS and that caused some boot loops and problems that you couldn't log in on specific Macs. And here specifically iMac 15.1 and 17.1, that is 2014 to 15 iMac, and MacBook Pro 11 5 and 13 3, that is also 2015 or 16 MacBook Pro. So if you own one of these Macs, that problem should be solved as well. So these were the big points, but there were some more improvements that are only mentioned in the change log itself. And I just want to give you a hint what has changed in the patcher as well, because there are some quite handy features. The first one is that they implemented Wi-Fi only patches. So what does that mean? Maybe you had the problem that you installed the OpenCore Legacy patcher and you installed a new macOS, but the Wi-Fi was not recognized yet because you wanted to do the post-install root patch. But the post-install root patch requires an internet connection to download the KDKs, the kernel development kits from Apple. But as you didn't have any patches, there's no internet, so you couldn't download the KDK, so it didn't work. And now they added the Wi-Fi patches out of the root patch into the OpenCore Legacy patcher. That's the reason why it has around 600 megabytes. So you can do the Wi-Fi root patching offline, restart, then the Wi-Fi should be recognized. You can connect to your Wi-Fi to the internet, and then you do the root patch and download the KDK. Next thing is that they have a check if the OpenCore Legacy patcher has a different version than the one that booted your macOS. So it just reminds you, if you want to do the root patch with 0.6.1, but maybe you installed a 0.5.3 and booted from there, that the booted OpenCore is old. So you should update that first, so the versions always match before you do the root patch. So as I said, right now I'm in the process of updating my old unsupported Macs to macOS Ventura 13.2 with a new OpenCore Legacy patcher 0.6.1 and testing them a little bit. So I would give you an update in a few days if everything is fine, so that I can assure you that you can update your old unsupported Mac. I definitely will try to install Ventura on my cheese grater Mac Pro 5.1 from 2012 to see if that is working. And I definitely will update my Mac Pro 6.1 to Ventura 13.2 and check if the flaws that has been still there with 0.5 now are gone and that you can use it as a productive Mac Pro. Right now, I don't recommend Ventura on a Mac Pro 12 or 13. Give me some time and I definitely will incorporate that into the Ultimate Mac Pro Guide and give you some advice if it is worth it updating or not. Right now, for Mac Pro Cheese Grater and Mac Pro Trash Can users, Mac OS Monterey works rock solid in the latest version with the OpenCore Legacy Patcher 0.5.3. It's my workhorse here, so that should be no problem at all. Thanks for watching, stay tuned, remember to subscribe to the channel, and I will give you an update in a few days if it's safe to update your old Mac. Have a lot of fun on my channel. Bye-bye.